I often make my radio coils out of this wire. And in fact, it's a telephone wire that is, say, used in, say, old school telephone circuits. And by that idea, it consists of these wires here, red, orange, blank, blue, and there is also inserted somewhere a say kind of fabric wire, three fabric wires, and here it's white. The good thing about this, say, telephone cable is that the isolation material that they used in the Netherlands and perhaps everywhere has an extremely high quality, so that there is no loss due to, say, certain capacitive effects. The isolation of a copper wire is always, say, a kind of adventure in a certain way. It must be made in and tested in a scientific electromagnetic test. So that, for instance, here there's no leakage out of that pure copper coil to other, say, wires in that same cable. And when we are talking about, say, old school telephone technology, this was a very, very big issue, and you can even find on the World Wide Web. And when you study, say, old school telephone circuits, the big problem of, say, that one signal is sent here on one of these cables, and the distance is very long, the capacitive effect can make that one, say, telephone signals travels to another cable of the same telephone cable. So anyway, these were the problems that had to be solved in the 1920s, the 1950s, etc., etc. So capacitive influences between the wires inside, and there were made in the past extremely good solutions to solve that problem. Also about the length of the cable, so, say, energy loss of the audio signal that was sent into the cable to the other side anyway. For instance, pipin coils were used, and especially when you study, say, the 1950s technology of telephone cables, there are, say, many solutions, especially by using higher frequencies and typical modulation signals, etc., etc. I cannot go into detail here. The only aim of this video is a kind of vlog where I wanted to show that you can make a cable stripper. This is my cable stripper. Very, very easy to make with a knife here and a hole here in that wooden block, and that hole goes through and through, and with that, say, screw, you can align the knife so that it punches precisely into a cable, or this cable anyway. Here is, say, the cable after that is that it was strapped out of this, say, plastic mantle. And there you can see here, and you can also see that here, there are a few cables inside. So, a blank copper cable here, perhaps you can see it. Blank copper cable, a red isolated copper cable, an orange and a white copper cable, and of course all these fabrics. That means that when you, say, split such a telephone cable, there are some practical issues, especially when such a cable, say, starts to kink. And that's what happens here. And when you, say, take out the cable, and I want to demonstrate that I have to put the camera down for a very short time, as far as I know. And I put all the, say, cables. I put all the cables in this vise. And then you have to, say, wind out that cable. And that can give, say, serious problems, because on a certain moment when you, say, wind out that cable, it can start to kink, and that's here. Anyway, it will take some time, etc., etc. But you can, say, salvage a lot of very, very good, extremely good cables out of such an old school telephone wire. Anyway, that was more or less all to tell. When you want to know more about, say, telephone cables of the 1950s, of the 1920s, even the 1920s, search on the World Wide Web for, say, telephone cables and 1920s, 1950s, 1940s, and you will get very, very good information, especially about the damping of, say, telephone signals, when that cable was too long, so intermediate amplifiers that were made to amplify that the telephone signals, and cables that were laid into the oceans, telephone cables into the oceans, etc., etc. Say, it's a kind of ocean to explore. How they did it? They did to make a proper telephone connections in the 1920s and the 1950s via telephone cables in the Atlantic Ocean or whatever. This is of course not such a cable, that's nonsense, but anyway, this is a standard telephone cable made for household use, etc.